Hi, I'm Derek Briggs, Product Manager for Tsugami REM Sales. Today I'll be explaining the onboard data server that comes standard on all 5-axis capable Tsugami machines, why it's so important on these types of machines, and how to easily and correctly access the folder and its files. So the first step to using the onboard data server is really understanding what it's used for. And basically on the Tsugami 5-axis machines and multifunction machines, a lot of the surfacing programs can be very large file sizes. There's a lot of full 5-axis code, a lot of surfacing and profiling code that can really make that file size very large. And with the limited memory space on the CNC memory in a fan and control, which is 8 megabytes maximum, what they offer is this onboard data server that can give you up to 16 gigabytes of extra memory that you can actually access just like CNC memory on the machine. Now, having said that, the Tsugami machines with full 5-axis controls and the multifunction machines come with a 4 gigabyte data server as standard. Now, that can be upgraded to a 16 gigabyte fairly easily, but the 4 gigabyte is standard and should be more than enough for anything that you're trying to do as far as surfacing goes and file size. It's just a little bit more user memory. So step two then would be, how do I utilize this data server and how do I use it on the control function itself? And the first step is going to be to make sure that we can access it easily and load programs and save programs and access programs very easily. So first thing we need to do is check a parameter. I'm going to go to my system, hard key, and I'm going to type in 3233 number search. We want this PDM, this is bit 1, so 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, we want bit 1. If I go over to here, and I go to MDI, and I press 1 input, it's going to give me a write protect alarm. That's normal. We need to turn on parameter write enable. So I'm going to press the offset button 2 times, it's going to bring me to this settings screen, and I'm going to turn parameter write on by changing this number to a 1, 1 input. I'm going to get this alarm, no problem at all. We can move on with the alarm present. Back to system, it's going to bring me right back to where I was. I'm going to press 1, input. It's going to change that PDM to a 1, and it automatically changes main and back at the same time. So you don't need to change independently. If you change one path, it will change the other automatically. Now that we have that changed, I'm going to turn my parameter write enable back off by 0 input and reset my alarm, and we're all set there. Now what that did was actually made, if I go to my edit mode and I press program again here, and right now I'm in user path 1. You'll see foreground folder is user path 1, background folder CNC memory user path 1. If I go to the backside display, I'm going to be in CNC memory user path 2. This is the onboard CNC memory. This is your standard folder on any Tsugami machine, Swiss type machine, multifunction machine. CNC memory user path 1 or CNC memory user path 2 is completely standard. Now this would give you up to 8 megabytes. This control has 2 megabytes as standard, but with the 4 gigabyte data server, we need to access that in our foreground folder. So by turning that parameter on that we just did, if I press OPRT, device change, and I go to the data server, not the data server host, just the data server here. Now, I'm displaying my data server folder. There's nothing in here right now, but it shows here how much storage space I have, just under 4 gigabytes. So it's more than enough than you should ever need. But my foreground folder here and my background folder are still CNC memory user path 1. So my machine is actually reading from this file path. What's in here does not necessarily match what the machine is actually reading from. We need this to say data server. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to do foreground change and background change with the data server active. So it's going to take this current folder and make it my foreground and background folders. By turning that parameter on, 3233 bit 1, that allowed for these buttons to even show up. These would not exist, they wouldn't be here, so you wouldn't be able to do this foreground and background change without turning that parameter on first. So I'm going to press foreground change, and you'll see foreground folder is now data server. And I'm going to say background change, also data server. There's nothing in here, so if I press program, what's called up right now is actually CNC memory user path 1, and that's okay. We're going to now take a program from the USB memory and load it onto the data server. So I'm going to do my main side program first. We'll go back to folder, operator, device change, USB memory, just like we normally would. Now I want to take this very large file. So this is 738 kilobytes. Most part programs on Swiss type machines and your normal 2-3 axis lathes are going to be under 5 kilobytes. They're going to be maybe 10, maybe 2, maybe 3 kilobytes, very small file sizes because they're text files. And when you start getting into surfacing files, it's a lot of small moves, and you're going to see a lot of programs that are this size or even larger. So I'm going to arrow down to my 1119 program. I'm going to soft key right, press F input, F get, F set, and execute. Now it's going to input that program into my data server folder because that is my foreground folder. That is the folder I had selected as foreground prior to loading from the USB. Now given that these are very large files that are typically being transferred from one memory card to the data server, it may take a little extra time loading it. That's not abnormal to see this take a little bit longer than usual. So our program is loaded, we're done flashing input down to the bottom right. And if I press my program button now, I have 1119 and you'll see data server is now my foreground folder. Now what about my user path 2? I can have both programs, path 1 and path 2, in the data server, or I could have one program in the data server and the other program in the CNC memory. It doesn't matter. The machine, as long as you have your foreground folder set properly for each path, it doesn't matter if one is in the data server and one is in CNC memory. You can mix and match wherever you need to have that extra storage space. So for this video, I am going to actually do the backside program as well, the path 2, so you can see exactly how the file name has to be named in order for this to work properly. So because the data server is only one folder, and you're going to have multiple paths in that one folder, you have to be able to separate what's path 1 from what's path 2 within that data server folder. So if I'm going to go back to folder, now you notice on my USB memory, I have .p-2 programs. That is what you want to store on your USB memory. You want to actually do the file type .p-2. That's what's going to tell the machine that that is a path 2 program. Now before I actually load this program onto the data server, what I need to do is I need to change my foreground folder and background folder on backside or NC2 or path 2, whichever you'd like to call it. I need to change that to the data server as well. So if I go to the backside of my display or NC2 and I go to data server, now you'll see my foreground folder is user path 2. I need this to also read data server. So if I say foreground change, background change. Now my foreground and background are both data server. Now I can go back to my USB. Okay, that's USB. And I'm gonna take this 1152 program and I'm gonna load that onto the data server because it's selected as my foreground folder. Now that should be loaded on. If I press program, hard key, now my 1152 is loaded in into the data server. So it's very critical when loading programs from USB to the data server and running programs on the data server that foreground and background folders are in fact data server. If you wanted to change back, what you would do is go back to your OPRT, device change, CNC memory. So whatever folder is active here, I'm going to say soft key right, foreground change, background change. Now I'm back to user path 2. If I want to go back to the data server, device change, data server, foreground change, background change. And now you can see one folder rather than two different paths. You have one data server folder. you'll see that this little asterisk next to here, and then you have an ampersand. Because it's path 2 and it's 1152.p-2, it knows that this program is what's active in path 2, or my backside display. If I go to main side now, 1119 is now the at symbol, and the 1152 is now the asterisk. So it changes. That's how the machine knows the .p-2 file as you load it in. That's how it knows main or backside. So I have my 1119, my 1152, main and back, both are on the data server, and I can run this program and edit it, whatever I'd like to do, just as though it was on the CNC memory. If I wanted to delete these programs, what I would need to do is either call up a different program within the data server, because you cannot delete a program that's currently active. So let's say I want to delete 1119. If I try to do that right now, let's just go back to folder, I say operator, let's go to delete and execute. It's going to say removing the file failed from the ATA card. That's the data server card. Okay, so now let's go OPRT, device change, CNC memory. I'm just going to select this program I happen to have in my user path 1. I'm going to call that the main program. Now I also want to change foreground and background. Now CNC memory, user path 1. 9001 is called up. Now I can go into my device change, data server, and I can delete my 1119 program. Gone. The backside, same thing. I have to call up a different program. So if I say device change, CNC memory, I'm going to go here and call that my main program. And I'm going to change my foreground and my background. CNC memory, user path 2. We're good there. CNC memory user path 2. Go back to my device change, data server, and I can go ahead and delete my program. So I'm going to go through loading it and then output it to the card. I am going to go to the data server, which we're here. I'm going to go to path 1. I'm going to call that foreground and background. I'm going to go back to the USB, USB memory. Now we're going to input. So now that we have the program on our data server, and that's what's called up, that's our foreground folder. Now we want to output that to the card. So in order to do that, I'm actually going to delete it from the USB memory, just so I don't try to overwrite it. Let's go ahead and delete and execute. Okay, so now that there's no 1119, device change, data server, and I'm going to say F output, program set, or program get, my apologies, program set, and execute. Now it's outputting to the USB. So if you wanted to make any edits or you have a good proven process, save it back to your USB and go ahead and put that on your company server. And that is how you access the data server and use it. Thank you very much for your time.